we've been talking about it all off. It's incredible. I've been enjoying it. It's really awesome. Well, it's cool to see, because it's not about the money, right?
But
it's just about, there's so many other factors, and the fact that, you know, his culture plays so much into it, and the culture of what the French clubhouse is, how that all meshed together.
It's really flavor like cheese sandwiches and soda, it sounds like.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like.
Love it.
Incredible.
It explains that he left the 100-plus man on the table to come back out. So wait for it. Right.
All right, we got a bunch of social media stuff. I know you guys are going to be pretty excited about this, or you're going to completely ignore me. Either way, we're going to do it today on the show.
I do love it.
Okay, sounds good. I'm down for Nick. So we're going to start off with Jose Altuve, who was the biggest story, obviously, before we start talking about Shohei Ohtani. Look who's on the cover of Sports Illustrated with J.J. Watt. Mr. Chicago 17 AL MVP. Houston strong there. Obviously, we know J.J. Watt donated millions to Hurricane Relief, and then World Series winner there in Jose Altuve. What a strength there on one cover.
That's cool. Is this the first time that they've, or is this, have they done this in the past, where they call it the Sports Person of the Year? It used to be Sports Sports of the Year.
Yeah, it's been Sports
Person now. That wasn't as inclusive as it should have been.
Yeah, I think they changed that recently.
Yeah, yeah. That's a cool cover, though.
Yeah, and I love the fact that the two of them, obviously, completely, you know, passed through that entire season.
So they called persons, or was just, they say, hey, come hang with me. No, no, they both got it.
They both got it. Yeah, absolutely. All right, a bunch of other guys doing some stuff this offseason. Jason Kipnis, I don't know if you guys remember this, in the Cayman, hanging out with the Seals. He also spent some time in Maui, and then on the way back, after a fantastic vacation, airline lost luggage, and that's never good. I know, this is my biggest pet peeve with flying, is that you come home, sometimes your stuff doesn't come with you.
They're not upset about that.
At home, then when you get to work,
Harold knows all about that, Alexa, when he went to Canada and after defending an entire nation, they purposely lost his bags after the World Series of 2004. Too short.
Yeah.
We'll get to that in the next moment.
No, we'll talk about it. Yeah.
We also have Gary Sanchez, who is enjoying his offseason as well. He's doing a little bit of hiking out in Machu Picchu. He's got to drink his tea. He's just the altitude, by the way, if you weren't aware. And he is wearing an alpaca poncho. Look at that.
Got to drink more than you should put that on.
Yeah. Got his whole family, and then his girlfriend also hanging out with him, so he's getting a good culture in this offseason. Back to your stateside, though, we have the Angels, who completely opened their doors to the Eagles, who are on the West Coast facing the Rams on Sunday. And it was pretty cool. I bet Mike Trout had something to do with this. I wonder if they brought in cheesesteaks, though. That was the most important part to me.
Wait a minute, so they're doing their walk-ups and stuff?
No, they stayed out on the West Coast instead of coming back, so they spent the whole week practicing out there.
Yeah.
You know, Angel Stadium is to be the home of the Rams.
Yeah.
So, football.
Yeah, but it's baseball only forever. They could have found a high school or something, so they wanted to live there. I've been Mike Brown.
I guess so. Well, and I love it, too. They basically were talking to his mom, Debbie. They're like, we bring friends over, like the entire team, and everyone just go over your house and you can see them all. That would be pretty interesting. All right, then also, we got the Red Sox fan who was celebrating the 10th anniversary of Here Comes the Pizza. I hadn't seen this before, by the way, so if you haven't seen it either, you're going to thank me after this.
Left side, this is the now coming to Anderson. Anderson, good with all. 15 stands, left by a little tip, 10 of 10. Wow, less than they had four. Between innings, this investigative reporting. What is known as that gentleman, and that gentleman has been injected with an ugly, ugly sight. And I don't know why it's necessary. Now watch. I can't circle. I don't have my telespreader paper. Why? Here comes the pizza, please. Oh, geez.
Highly unnecessary.
So, they run over, and here comes the pizza.
The best part of the whole thing is that a Red Sox fan wanted to remember this for every day for the rest of his life. And instead of just pulling up his laptop and opening up and watching it on YouTube, he decided to get it tattooed to his body. So he's got pizza slice on his arm with the date to commemorate this very important moment.
The guy that got hit with the pizza got the tattoo, or just some random?
Just some random.
No, the guy who threw it did that. Amazing.
Yeah, so this is something that he's going to remember for the rest of his life. So if everyone has.
England fans, they are their own.
Yeah, absolutely.
Guy in a Patriots jacket chucking pizza at a guy rooting for the same
team. We don't know who that was that threw that pizza. I think we have to do our best to find out who that was.
You plan a bit here without telling anybody, or like,
speculating. game. We can make one of the camera camera chips.
Okay. Sounds good. All right. Coming up here on the show, James Stewart joins us to talk about the 50 greatest A's of all time. We also have Dan Tillman.
Eric Burns made that.
Give us a little bit of info. Yes, we'll talk about that later on in the show. Tillman's going to tell us a little Eric Boone. Here's how you contact us, by the way, in case you were wondering. Here's up on